Okay. This is the guy you normally see, right? Yeah, and this is the guy you're normally seeing. But you know, if you put a video camera in my head, what will you see? This is the guy you'll see here. Okay, now since TED doesn't pay me too much and they dragged me all the way from another country called Mumbai, okay, into Navi. I'm going to give the choice to you. Do you want this guy to present or you want this guy to present? The first guy or the second guy? Everybody wants this one? TEDx, you guys are in trouble, okay? Yeah. Okay, so in 2014, I decided to give up my corporate career and get into the science of happiness. A lot of people said, really? Science of happiness? You know, can I teach that? Okay, and that was the first reaction, okay? And let me do some market research. I went to Bing and I said, why am I? And this is what comes out. Obviously, there's a market, okay? People thinking, why am I useless? Why am I so awkward? And this guy even is searching for, why am I so useless? Obviously, talking about, okay? And I said, maybe Bing, Bill Gates, he obviously has it wrong. Let's go to the powerhouse of the world, Google, okay? And this is what Google comes up with, okay? Obviously, there's a huge market out there. And I said, let me add one more word, and this is true, okay? This is true. I added one word, which was a mind-boggling word called still. Okay? And I did the word still. Okay? The third from blast will resonate with a lot of you. Not. Okay? And I was also wondering about this. And I heard Warren Buffett say this. Okay? Warren Buffett said, too many people are miserable at work. And ma'am, you said that you get a job that you... Right? How many of you are in the job that you love doing? Put your hand up. Okay, out of 100 out here, 4.5 or something. Okay, fantastic. Right? And Warren Buffett said, too many people are miserable at work. This is what he says. Okay. And it's Warren Buffett. If you disagree with him, you obviously don't like money, okay? And Chris Peterson, who studies the late Chris Peterson, okay, one of the founders of applied positive psychology, and he said something very interesting. He said positive psychology has two tenets, okay? First is that positive psychology is not a spectator sport. What does that mean, by the way, not a spectator sport? Anybody? What does it mean? Come on. You have to participate. You cannot be the guy, just wear a t-shirt and you'll be happy, okay? Even though the guy got 3 lakhs, do it, okay? I need to check his IQ, okay? I mean, why won't you take 3 lakhs, for heaven's sake? People change their vote for 3 lakhs, okay? So first is, you have to participate. Second is, what Chris Peterson said is, other people matter. What does that mean, other people matter? Come on. Come on, enlightened audience. You got 8 speakers before me. What does it mean other people matter? Yeah. So first is, if you look at a clock, okay, other people matters is from 12 to 6, is that a lot of people have made a huge impact on your life, and the reason you are where you are today is because of other people. You agree with that? Put your hand up. Yeah. So other people have contributed to your life, and the balance 6 to 12 again is, and you may not believe this, but you are all Zoom is making a huge impact. Is the mic okay? Yeah. Yeah. Okay. I should. So far he is giving me the approval. So okay. So and the balance is about, check the okay. I will tie myself down to this one, okay? I like to gesticulate like the Italians, okay? So the balance is that each one of you in this room is making an impact on other people's lives. How many people believe that? Yeah, you know? And that's what it means by other people matter. And you know, we study fun stuff, some of the real fun stuff that we study. And here's a question for all of you. How did we communicate before language was born? Sign language. Which was the first sign language that we invented? Sorry?
The first was, okay, let's try this, okay? What I want you to do is, let me see if you guys get this, okay? I want you to greet your neighbor to your left and to your right quickly. Greet your neighbor to your left, greet your neighbor to the right quickly, 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 quickly. Say hello, namaste, come on, come on. Yeah, you got it, left and right, everybody did that? Some of you were lazy and I spotted, and some of you was, you know, like, okay, let me shake hand with this person, and okay, he's asking me to do it at 9:30, what's for dinner, okay? And so what was missing when you greeted each other? What was missing right now? Okay, the smiles were missing, right? Who has a better smile here? Okay, all the women went for Clooney, obviously, okay? And why do you think a smile is better? His eyes are smiling, and how do you know his eyes are smiling? Because when you see this, okay, this is called crow feet, okay? And this smile is called Duchenne smile, and Guillaume Duchenne, a psychologist, discovered this smile. So, okay, and what he found is that when it's a genuine smile, okay, how many people have you had taken a flight in the last 6 months? Yeah, you know, when you board the flight, you go up the stairs, there's an aerostress standing there, she's smiling at you, but she's not smiling at you. You got that, right? Okay. We call that the plastic smile, right? Okay. Whereas this is the Duchenne smile. So what I want you to do now is, neighbor to your left, neighbor to your right, piche, aage, give them a nice Duchenne smile. Quickly, come on, quickly, quickly. Big Duchenne smile. Come on, come on, come on, come on, come on, come on. Left, right, aage, piche, jaldi, 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 jaldi. Okay, excellent, okay. Now, when you gave each other a nice Duchenne smile, this is the most laziest table. I saw you not smiling. Come on. Okay? You're bringing down the average of energy on this side, by the way. Okay? Okay? And by the way, Johnson, this side was the noisiest, but this side is more good looking. Okay? So, in case you didn't know that. Yeah? Just in case you didn't know that. Okay? Now, when you smiled at each other, how did your shoulders feel? Did you suddenly feel relaxed? Did your attention suddenly come back to this room, away from the paneer pasanda, which is, okay, for the vegetarians, that is politically correct one to say, okay? So what happens is, when you smile, okay, it a whole lot of endorphins, just like when you dance, a whole lot of hormones, mainly serotonin and oxytocin. So when you smile, and Ron Goodman says this really well, and now you know why you like Barack Obama, right? Yeah? Any Trudeau fans? Any Real Madrid fans? Now you can see the Duchenne smile, right? Okay, now think about it. When you met, how many people had an arranged marriage here? Okay, how many people had a love marriage here? Okay, how many people had a crush in your lives? Yeah, okay, all of you had a crush in your life. And you know, when you met this person for the first time, okay, after how many months did you realize, hey, maybe I have a crush on this person? Did it take days, months? The answer is 30 seconds, because what we find is that when you look at each other, and in 30 seconds, your brain decides, okay? And here's the best thing. When we see that aerostress with a plastic smile, okay, we don't trust the people. Dude, you already have a good-looking body. Don't smile, okay? I mean, I wanted to know, how do you wear such a tight shirt? I have to wear 48, okay? And here's the funny thing. And Ron Gottman in his book Smile says this, okay, that when you see a happy person with a happy smile, okay, you rate that person to be more happy, content, trustworthy, welcoming, competent, and intelligent. Okay, now you know why I have to smile, because I'm none of those. Okay, and you know, UNESCO discovered, they said, you know, the smile is so important, we must find out which is the best smile in the world. Okay? So they got psychologists, biologists, etc., aestheticians from all over the world, and they found out the best smile in the world. Would you like to see the best smile in the world? Yeah. You know, but they said, bahut kharcha ho gaya. Okay? Just like how we build certain stuff, and you know, then we say, oh, damn expensive, yaar. Okay? So they said, you know, whoever sees the best smile in the world has to pay $10. Would you be willing to pay $10? Okay, since this is an NPO, I will get you a bulk discount, $2, okay, to see the best smile in the world, $2. Will you be willing to pay $2? Yeah, okay, this is the best smile in the world. Okay, and the funny thing is, and that's why happiness is so easy, okay? So I'm going to ask you a question, okay, and fill in the blanks. I will be happy when, I'll be happy when, quickly. Okay, or I'll be happy if, tell me, what makes you happy? What makes you happy? Tell me fast, don't laugh at me, I haven't put you on the spot. What makes you happy, fast? Okay, listening, ma'am, what makes you happy? Cooking, what makes you happy, sir? A bottle of beer, ma'am, what makes you happy? Your mother's smile. There's a word for all of you, okay? And that word is liars, because 80% of the people in this world... obviously a sore point, okay? And here's the funny thing, okay? India's wealth is going up. 2016, okay, we were 122nd on the World Happiness Report. Last year, we were 133. Okay, we are having a tough fight with Afghanistan, by the way. And you know, how many people had mothers who told them, beta padle? All of you. And she said, beta padle, taake tu pass hoga, teri shaadi hogi. And then what will happen? You will be happy. Correct? Right? And turns out not. Turns out not. Okay. And what we find is the reverse. People who are positive, sir, like you, big round of applause, sir, like you. Okay. Positive people like you work harder, work smarter, and they're more successful. Okay? And that's what we find, that the equation actually is reversed. And there's some fascinating studies about this. They took nuns and they found out the happiest, and a long story, I'll cut it short. What they found is the happiest nuns, okay, and they took a convent and they categorized convents in happy, very happy nuns, happy nuns, unhappy nuns, very unhappy nuns. What they found is, by age 85, the very happy nuns were alive. Okay, he's asking me to come in the middle. Okay, sorry. Okay. Oh, yeah. Okay. Okay. And what they found was only 34% of the unhappy nuns were alive. The average difference between very happy nuns and unhappy nuns was close to 8 years. Okay, and that means it tells you that the happiness dictated how long you will live. Okay, and interestingly, what we also find is, from the Framingham studies, if you are happy, your friends are happy, your friends' friends are happy, and your friends' friends' friends are happy. Okay? And interestingly, not only happiness, but depression, fashion, smoking, charity, suicide, voting, okay, excepting one. If you got promoted, your friends didn't become very happy around there. Okay? That was the only exception. And here's the interesting thing that Lyubomirsky discovered. Your happiness, 50% of your happiness is fixed, is genetic. 10% of your happiness depends upon how much you earn, your income, everything. And 40% is on your personal behaviors. Okay? And that happiness has a huge impact on every aspect of our lives. Right? And there's a huge scientist base of people who are studying applied positive psychology. Okay? And people will wonder, okay, happiness and silent water. Because, and you know, you're talking about sport, here's a sport bigger than sport. Okay, because, and here's the impact, everything happens silently here, okay? We start with one and suddenly we have all these, you know? Okay, and here is the, and you know, people said, what is TED? I said, TED is Tandoori and English Daru, because if you look at this, okay? And because if you look at this, we start off like this and we become like this in sooner or later, okay? And everything is silent. So, you know, this is bandstand and that's silent water, right? Okay, and is this silent water also? Right? Because there could be a little guy surfing those waves who's completely in the silent water. Correct? So is that silent water for you? Or even just a brook flowing in a 1 footstep of water could be happy. Even, and this is silent water too. Okay? So the point I'm making is that it doesn't matter. Okay? Like water takes different forms, silent water takes different forms. Happiness takes different forms. And interestingly, happiness is everywhere. Okay? And I'm going to teach you, okay? But let me see if you're ready to become happier people. Okay? What I want you to do is, I want you to count these numbers as they appear on stage loudly. Okay? So what's the, and you have to count, you have to add the numbers. Okay? So what's the number? Okay, now add. Louder, louder, okay? Whoever said 5,000, I want to do business with you. Okay? Because what happened is we got into what we call mindlessness. Okay? You got into a pattern like a crowded local train. Okay? And therefore, what I'm saying is you can find your own reasons to be happy. And I'm going to teach you the what happened. Okay? So the first way of being happy, it starts with a smile. Correct? Okay? And now, how to increase happiness in your life? Everybody got these smiley stickers? 5 minutes left? 5 minutes left. Okay, I'm told you're talking too much. Just 5 more minutes. People are hungry. Okay? The most dangerous word which starts with H and Y. Okay? How to increase positivity in your life? Everybody's got these smiley stickers? Okay? And you know, Neil, you said something fantastic. We all have superpowers, right? But each one of us have superpowers embedded within us. What I want you to do is take out the smiley sticker. Okay? And so, for example, you, sir, okay, we'll pick up any one person, okay, go with the smiley sticker, and you will pick up this gentleman who's holding onto his helmet like it was his wife, okay? Come, get up. What I want you to do is share quickly what is your superpower with him, okay? And if you like the superpower that he tells you, you will give him one smiley sticker on his shoulder, and then you will share that. I want you to do this very quickly, all of you, with three of your neighbors, share three smileys, tell them what is the superpower you bring to this world. Quickly, come on, with three of your neighbors, three of your friends, okay? Quickly. Come on, you don't have stickers? Somebody please give out stickers, some more stickers, please. Share your superpower with her and she will share and you give her a sticker when you hear it. Okay? Quickly. Share your superpower with each other. Give each other a sticker. Quickly. Hello. Okay, hopefully one done. Quickly share your superpower. Quickly share. Thank you for that. You got it. Are three people you're supposed to share with. Three people. Quickly. Three people, everybody. Okay, settle down, everybody, settle down. Settle down, everybody. Okay, the noisy left, come on, settle down. Okay, how did it feel? First of all, how much time did that take? A minute, right? How did it feel when you shared your superpower with somebody? How did it feel? It felt good, right? How did it feel when someone shared their superpower with you? How did that feel? Which was more intense? Okay, listening to someone else was more intense, right? Okay, and that comes into the realm of what we call gratitude. Okay? Gratitude is, and Robert Emmons does a fantastic amount of work on gratitude. Okay? And what he finds is that just listening to people and appreciating them for their superpowers, thank you, Neil, for that, once again, okay, for the 100th time. What he finds is very interesting. I won't run through all of this. What he finds is people who express gratitude are happier. Okay? They live healthier lives. And students, by the way, students who express gratitude get an extra 1 point grade in their academics, okay? And you know how tough that is, okay? You're smiling at me, by the way, okay? Okay, and all of you have three lit cards with you, okay? What I want you to do with this is this, okay? When you get back to work on Monday morning, find a person in your life who has inspired you, okay? Or somebody who's done something nice for you, write a little thank you note on that lit card and hand it over to that person. Is it doable? Okay, is that a promise you make? Yeah. Okay, so I've given you three. Do you know the impact if I've given you three and if those people forward it to three more people, by the end of the month, how many people get impacted? If that cycle takes place paid forward, if I give it to three people gave it to three people forward, in by 1 month, every person on this planet, I will tell you, okay? Every person in this planet will be impacted 29,000 times. That's the impact of gratitude, okay? And Robert Emmons says this fantastically. He says gratitude is not an app, it's an operating system. Okay? So it's not about let me practice it. It's when your mindset becomes that of gratitude. Okay? So I started with smile, went on to gratitude and the random acts of kindness. I'm gonna leave you with the fourth life hack. Anybody keen on the fourth life hack? Oh come on, give me some more encouragement. Anybody interested in the fourth life hack? Yeah. And I promise you, all of you have been inspired today, right? When you get back to work on Monday morning, you will fail again. You will go back. You would have forgotten everything. I guarantee you that. Okay? I mean, the brilliant amount of work. By the way, ma'am, when you say, you know, when she said, when I was young, I looked at her and I said, how can she say when she was young? She means today 12:30 or something, you know? When you're 22, you're not supposed to say when you are young, okay? Only when you become 222 like me, then you will say that. Okay? So what do you do when people around you fail or when you fail? What do you do? What's the fastest way of recovering from failure? Okay, Paul Zak, okay, and this is something gladiators did both in victory and in defeat. All our ancient Indian warriors did this in victory and defeat. Any idea? Okay, and this is the easiest way to bounce back from any failure, any negativity. This is the absolutely easiest way, but it's gonna make you very uncomfortable. Are you ready to try this? Okay, Paul Zak says you have to try this 8 times a day. If I show this trick to you, will you practice it 8 times today itself, just now? Any guesses, what is it? No, smile I've already covered. You're like students, you know, jo bata diya wohi syllabus mein. Okay, I'm going to show you a video, okay? If you get the hint, I want you to practice it right now with 8 different people, okay? But to practice this, I need all of you to stand up.
I don't mind where you come from, as long as you come to me.
Guys, 8 times. You know, hug 8 people. Hug 8 people. Hug 8 people. Hug 8 people. Thank you. Settle down. Did that feel good? Did that feel good? So just to wrap up, tomorrow will be a beautiful day. You promise that? I can't hear you. You promise tomorrow will be a beautiful day? Excellent. And you know, I hope the world becomes as beautiful as Aishwarya is trying to make it for all of us. Thank you so much for that. We live in a beautiful city, right? You agree with that? Yeah? I wish you all the very best. I wish that you learn from enlightened people like this. And I wish you that you learn from more enlightened people like the kid there. You promise to be that? Yes. You promise to be ambassadors of happiness when you step out? Yes. Excellent. Okay. I want you to be a sparkle with that. Thank you very much. It's been a pleasure being here.